right, so here's the thing on Truth Be Told today. We're going to look at all of the fake messaging that's going around about the coronavirus. Remember, and I know that you've seen it because it's on everybody's WhatsApp messages. There's a message that's that says that UNICEF has put out these these sort of instructions. It also says so-and-so doctor or so-and-so homeopath has put out these instructions. And a lot of that information is fake, which is why we're going to go through it one by one with the help of a friend and colleague, Sachi from Boom.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
So here's the thing. So I've seen this message because it's in all our WhatsApp messages. It says this doctor has made this list, that doctor has made. It's obviously fake. And I want to go over these pointers one by one so that we figure this out. The first one, and we put that on the screen, and you'll recognize this. It says the virus is very large in diameter, about 400 or 500 micro. I don't know what a micro is, but that's what it says. And so if you use a mask, even an ordinary like plain cloth mask, it will prevent, the virus cannot go through the mask because it's so fat, effectively. It's body shaming the virus. But that's not necessarily true. Do we know the size of this virus? Do we know if this is true?
Not yet. So, firstly, let's establish that the virus does not have a cell.
Okay.
A virus is an RNA replicating agent, and cells have DNA as a replicating agent. So, cell bodies have a bodies with DNA have a cell, are defined as cells, and virus are different entities altogether.
Okay.
The WHO has not discovered the size of the virus yet.
So, what is that like gold thing with like antennas that people are drawing all over the place?
So those basically are what viruses are made of. That's, and they've picked it up from how the HIV virus was started as an enveloped virus. So this is also an enveloped virus. The RNA is enveloped by another margin, but which is not a cell body.
Okay.
These are other acid-like things and other substances which the virus and the genome identifies and goes about replicating.
So we don't know how fat or thin this virus
Not yet. Not
so
yet.
Don't body shame the virus. And also, we don't know whether it can go through a mask or... So what is the deal with masks
so
right now?
Basically, the WHO has categorically stated that the mask will not be as effective as the world is claiming and thinking it to be. A lot of people from the public health sector believe that this is a good mechanism to destigmatize the mask. But it's also important to understand that the mask will not prevent the virus from going through.
So the virus can go through the mask?
It could, possibly. There's no research yet because this is a droplet-based mechanism virus. It's not going through air, which we come into the next point. It's a droplet mechanism. Now, if you've covered your mouth, does not mean it's not on the surface where you won't get it through. You're saving yourself this way. But it's also important that a healthy person wearing it won't help if a sick person is not wearing one.
Okay.
If somebody is infected and they are not wearing a mask, if they sneeze, if they cough, their droplets are reaching everywhere, including your mask. You are touching that mask. After that mask, you're touching your face. If you're not disinfecting your hands, if you're not washing your hands.
So the main carrier is your hands?
Predominantly, yes.
Because you're touching surfaces or someone. Yes. So basically, this is what we know. And let's also be very clear about the fact that the medical community is still figuring this out. Mm-hmm. So when someone who is infected is talking, and there's a certain amount of like droplets and spittle, when they're sneezing, when they're coughing, there's a radius on which this will fly through.
Yes.
It'll settle on surfaces. You touch that surface, then you touch your face. This is how it happens.
Yes,
right?
True.
Eyes, nose and mouth.
True.
All right, so it could go through my eyes as well.
It could. There is no possible study yet. As we've said, it's a very new virus.
So we don't
know. A new strain. So everything is still being researched. Everything is still being understood. Also, the WHO has asked to keep a 1 meter distance. Say that that's about 3 feet. But just as a precautionary measure, because you don't know fast this is spreading, how far this is going through as well.
Right. All right, so the next thing that it says is this virus is not transmitted by air. Again, can we say that this is true or this is false?
This is a partly true, partly false kind of a mechanism. A lot of science is like that. A lot of science is grey. So when we mean that this is a droplet-based mechanism, when we mean this is a surface-based mechanism, does not only mean that it won't pass through air. Now, if supposedly I was infected and if I'm speaking to you without a mask, you're right in my line of sight. Before it can reach a surface, it is also going to pass through you. So... Mm. The droplets are being transmitted through air as well. It's not completely airborne if the person does not cover themselves.
Breathing the same air as you is not going to get me infected, but droplets that are coming out of your mouth...
If you're around me when I'm coughing or sneezing, they could land on you. Yes.
Okay, all right. So the next one that we want to look at is the idea that this, and this is important, guys, okay, that the virus can live on a surface or a metal surface for 12 hours. We don't know who measured that. We don't know if that's
we
true.
Don't know the measurement. The World Health Organization has said that this could, this does stay on surfaces, but the duration of which is not decided. Now, the duration depends and changes from the kind of surface it is on, from the humidity in the area, from the temperature in the area, from the kind of geographical area it is in. So, a lot of science and geography comes into play. You can't have a decisive figure stating that, okay, this is the virus, this is this surface, it's going to stay on this surface for this long. That is why they're saying disinfect your surfaces after touching it, or before, or disinfect your hands after you've immediately touched something if you don't want to go about disinfecting surfaces. That is why the WHO, the first primary precautionary measure was wash your hands.
Yes. And also all of these surfaces that are touched a lot by a lot of people, lift buttons, for example, doorknobs, staircases, you know, especially in public places, a lot of people tend to touch these spaces
local
as opposed to in your house.
Local
oh my God,
rods.
The local
So like
train.
A lot of people I have seen these couple of days get in, including me. I don't wear the mask, but including me, once I'm on the train, I'm sanitizing my hands because I'm jumping in, I'm touching the road. I don't know how many people have touched
it. Put
it because
on your head at this point.
Totally.
I mean, the local train that way, if you're talking about a 3 meter distance and, you know, coughing and droplets and things like that. I mean, I'm hoping that the government is currently working on a solution for the local train, because that could be
but again,
very disruptive.
There is where my opinion comes in. A lot of public health professionals also believe this, that the masks that are being used and people are aware and people are wearing them, but more than creating awareness, it's also creating panic and fear in the minds of people who are not wearing them.
No, so I'll tell you something. So here's, so effectively, this is what I know, and correct me if I'm wrong, that if someone is infected and that person wears a mask, it will prevent the droplets from falling on other people, right? So effectively, the mask is preventing those droplets.
But only if an infected person is wearing
only
it.
The
we don't know who
for
is infected.
For a non-infected person, doesn't wearing the mask sort of mentally in some place make you aware of the fact that, listen, everything is not normal? Because I know that, you know, both of us are sitting here, for example, we know we shouldn't touch our faces.
Yeah.
We know we shouldn't touch surfaces. But we tend to constantly forget that.
That's true.
But if I were wearing a mask, I'd be perpetually reminded of the fact that something's up.
That's
and I
true.
Need to be more aware.
But
the problem is hoarding, right?
Yes, the hoarding and the kind of fear it's creating in people's heads. Because if you see one person wearing and another person goes back home and says, we should get a mask, we should get a mask. Masks that were being sold for one and a half rupee, say 2 weeks ago, are now being sold at 25 plus.
Okay. So I'll be honest here and I'll confess. So I had taken a flight to Bangalore about a week ago and I bought a mask at the airport sort of pharmacy and I used it, and of course everybody on social media went bonkers saying, oh, you're creating panic. But I do believe that, first of all, don't hoard. If you really feel the need to buy a mask and keep yourself safe, one mask is enough. And ordinary masks, you don't
for
have to buy
for a couple of days.
For a couple of days. At least you don't have to buy, don't buy six is my point. Okay. But, you know, there's it's about whatever makes you feel safe. And if you are someone who feels that you don't need a mask because you're well-read and you're aware, then good on you as well. Let's move on to the next one. This is an important one. Exposure to the virus, exposure of the virus to the sun will kill it if you expose it to bright sunlight within 2 hours. Now, this is, again, I've seen this in a lot of WhatsApp messages. Can sunlight kill the virus?
Nothing as of now.
Not that we know.
Not sunlight. The next point of temperatures, high temperatures.
Yes, I was
going to
say. So here's the thing. And I got this forward from someone who said, here is a map of the world. These are the cold sections. These, you know, red areas are the hot sections. And it's only passing in these sort of, you know, yellow areas of the map. Is that true? Have the doctors confirmed that high temperatures will kill it? Because then in India, we're good, man. Remember, summer's coming.
So, the health ministry yesterday stated this, that there is no study confirming this theory, which is what a lot of fact checkers, a lot of scientists have also been saying. We know that normal, since it's like a cold virus giving flu-like symptoms, normal cold-like, cold-giving and flu-like viruses are highly active during the cold temperatures. But they tend to be inactive when the temperatures rise. For now, we can say it could probably be inactive, but till we don't reach those temperatures, we can't definitively say that it's going to die.
Also, a lot of this comes from the experience of the influenza epidemic of the early 1900s. And it came back when winter came back.
True.
So it's not exactly, I mean, something that We don't have winter in India for large portions of our country, but still, there's no scientific basis.
Kerala right now is above 30, 32, and Kerala has a good 14 cases, confirmed cases. So, we really are not sure if the temperature theory exists. Yes, they brought it from somewhere, but people who got in touch with them
Singapore,
also got it.
Which is like a permanent sort of tropical summer going on in Singapore, right? Australia, which is in its summer
which is in summer right now.
So this temperature thing is not proven scientifically, at least. It sounds like a good idea, but it hasn't been proven scientifically. The virus lives on your hands for only 10 minutes.
We don't know how long it lives for. Disinfect your hands, clean them, yes. Now again, there's just one change here. Not everybody gets a sanitizer. Sanitizers are also being hoarded. Sanitizers are made of alcohol, which tend to dry your skin at some point of time. Use them, but don't get too frequent with them. Normal soap and water is a better alternative to than using a sanitizer all the time.
Stay away from ice cream and cold food, which will prevent an infection. Now, we've already completely ruined the market for poultry and eggs. Apparently, ice cream is next on the list.
Yes, it is.
But again, there's no... this is just equating what gives you a cold
to... Yes, exactly. So, it's taking normal... theories which we've already heard and we tend to follow and pasting it with the recent outbreak of coronavirus.
Okay. Gargling with warm water can prevent the virus from leaking into your lungs.
So for us, when we were debunking this, first we were just completely unclear as to what does this state.
Yes.
Because what do you mean by leaking into the lungs? What do you mean that the virus is going into the lungs? What route is the, what is the mechanism?
I will tell you. So basically, this is what the WhatsApp forward says, that the virus tends to settle somewhere, or it's living somewhere near your tonsils. And so if you gargle with very hot water, because temperature kills the virus, and you swallow, it will wash it into your stomach, where the stomach acid will kill the virus, as opposed to it leaking into your lungs if this doesn't happen. It's very complicated, very like, you know.
Like the hydrochloric acid is acting faster only if. So again, we've heard this salt water and hot water theory when you have a normal cough. Equating that with the current outbreak is thinking too fast and thinking too soon about things which we're not, which we've not understood yet.
Actually, we should also put it out here that for all the medical science, you know, work that we've done in this world, there is no cure for the common cold. And the gargling actually just relieves the symptoms. It just gives you comfort from the coughing and the dry throat or whatever else you're feeling when you're unwell. It doesn't cure it or wash anything into your stomach, really, does it?
And that is why the WHO is also stating there is no cure for this one yet.
Yeah.
People have been talking about vaccines. People have been talking about a lot of things, but no cure has been developed yet.
Homeopathy? No.
Only if. There's, again, no scientific evidence. But if it is helping, again, our country follows so many different schools of medicines and we've agreed upon this in health, everybody's agreed upon this in health, that health being a grey area, something that works for me might not work for you and vice versa. So if it is keeping some people happy, go ahead with it. But scientifically, homeopathic drugs haven't been proved to calm down the symptoms.
Okay, so if you're taking homeopathic medicine or Ayurvedic medicine to boost your immunity, which is fundamentally what those forwards are asking you to do, nevertheless, still wash your hands.
Yes, definitely. Don't stop washing your
hands. Don't stop washing your hands. Still wash your hands. Sanitize as many surfaces as you can. Avoid crowded public places. Avoid swimming, like public swimming pools and gyms as much as possible. Or at least make sure that you're not touching your face when you're in these spaces. And as soon as you find yourself with any symptoms at all,
consult a doctor.
Go to the doctor. Do not self-medicate. Yes. Correct?
Also, eat cooked food. Do not eat raw food because we don't know the source of the virus yet.
And we don't know. Obviously, so here, we don't know if someone sneezed on the raw food.
That.
We don't know if someone sneezed on the raw food. See, I mean, you know how especially, we're always told to eat cooked hot food. Will the cooking kill the virus?
It'll inactivate it if deactivate it if nothing else, because again the temperature theory comes into play. But since again we don't know what the source is, so if this is the source, we can say that probably this is keeping it, killing it or keeping it inactive for sure.
Right. So all of the things we learnt in school about being clean, you have to follow now. So wash your hands for at least 20 seconds. Sing happy birthday twice. That's 20 seconds. And stay away from crowded places. Avoid travel unless you really have to. Try and stay home as much as possible. And my appeal to all of you is that if you're going to be working from home, in order to stay safe, then the people who work in your homes, like your maids and cooks and your drivers, also give them time off so they can also be safe. Thanks for watching Truth Be Told. Leave me more questions in the comment section and we'll do more shows for you. Bye-bye.